hear the sound of waves gushing behind. But instead of pristine sand, you see piles of plastic waste and debris. This is the harsh reality of today. We have tons of plastic waste that ends up in our landfills and oceans, threatening marine life and contributing to climate change.
Here in Australia, plastic waste is a really big problem. Our beautiful coastline and marine ecosystem are taking a huge hit from all the discarded plastic. It's heartbreaking to see how much it affects our wildlife, from seabird to marine creatures. But it doesn't stop there. It impacts our community as well.
This is where Plastic Solution Project, aka PSP, comes into play. PSP mitigates environmental damage and promotes a sustainable path. It benefits marine life, especially lowers the risk of plastic entanglement and injury. PSP was established or initiated in 2018 at Victoria University, and since then it has a major impact on our community.
At PSP, we've engaged with stakeholders from environmental organizations, educational institutions, and local communities, such as Griffith University and the Vegan Club, to tackle this pressing issue.
As we tackle the fundamental problem for plastic waste, our process is both systematic and impactful, ensuring that every step contributes to our goal of sustainability. Our journey begins with the collection of the plastic waste. Our volunteers go to neighborhood, community cafes, restaurants, and public spaces. Like insurance, we get the enough plastic caps to do the next step.
Once collected, we separate all the plastic from the dirt and contamination. This is where the collected plastic undergoes to a true cleaning process to remove dirt. After cleaning, the plastics are sorted into different types. The types are 2, 4, and 5. We separate plastic. We also separate plastic into different colors to maintain the consistency to our finished product. This shredding, once sorted, the plastic are shredded into smaller, manageable pieces. The shredding step is prepared for extrusion. This is where the real magic begins.
A wonderful team of engineers at Victoria University built the shredding machine on campus. We've also received funding from Victoria University to build the extrusion machine. And in the extrusion phase, the shredded plastic is melted and molded into new forms. These forms are then separated and sorted to determine the best use for each piece, whether it be a clock, a plant pot, a sturdy plastic bean, or even a unique trophy. This meticulous sorting process ensures that every recycled plastic finds a new purpose.
We invited you to watch a short video about how the plastic finds a new purpose. Our impact extends beyond our recycling process. In 2024, we delivered 13 workshops, partnering with the organizations like Griffith University and TAFE students in our university, and also the Vegan Club. Also, Griffith University started up their own project after attending our workshops. These workshops are more than educational sessions. They are transformative experiences that empower the participants to be our contributors to our mission. Our team efforts have been extraordinary. This year alone, 130 volunteers dedicated a total of 373 hours to our mission. Together, we created various products from the recycled plastic 8.44 kilograms of plastic pots, 31.36 kilograms of plastic beams, 1 ton box, 1 plastic clock, and 53 trophies. Each product symbolizes our commitment to the sustainability and creativity.
Our action resonates throughout the community, from participating in Environment Day to organizing workshops for the vegan group. And engaging in the People, Place and Talent Festival and OFEST, we actively promote our mission and expand our reach. The data speaks volumes about our impact. Our recycling efforts have significantly reduced plastic waste in our community. This is not just about the numbers, it's about creating a sustainable community. Through our structured process and community-driven impact, we are not just recycling plastic, we are redefining waste management and fostering a culture of sustainability.
We've had volunteers from all of the U campuses join our workshops and contribute towards this program. We've even had academically challenged individuals join in the sorting process. This has helped them develop their sorting skills as well as intellect. Our
business goal ensures sustainability and growth. By selling these eco-friendly products, which is the pots, we not only cover operational costs, but also we invest in expanding our recycling capacity. Partnership with the local businesses and organizations like the Vegan Group strengthen our outreach and also impact, amplify our mission across the region. Our revenue stream includes the revenue from selling pots for $750 and running workshops for organizations like the Brooks University for $100 and the groups like the Vegan Group about $150 and also the EU10 placement students for $700. And our crowdfunding for the new mode is $2,150.
In addition to our workshop, we also utilize our social media platform effectively to integrate and yield impressive results. Just from our YouTube channel, we have experienced a remarkable of 78.4% growth attributed to engaging shots and sustainable 34% increase from our longer video content. Amid this achievement, we remain steadfast in our commitment to sustainability goals, particularly in advocating for the 3 R's. Reduce plastic waste, promote recycling initiatives, and encourage reuse practices. These principles not only guide our operation, but also underscore our dedication to making a positive environmental impact through outreach and actionable initiatives.
We have created opportunities for students to get involved with Enactus by creating hackathons and workshops where they get to brainstorm for ideas and create innovative solutions. They even build prototypes of the products they'd like to create using this recycled plastic. Looking ahead, our long-time goal is to scale up the recycled plastic waste by increasing the amount of plastic recycling and to create educational programs for future generations to get inspired and to prioritize environmental care. Our social media team has harnessed new heights by creating awareness through social media and building meaningful changes through the social media platforms and websites.
Not only that, PSB is not just recycling plastic into just pots, it's more about creating an impact to our community, creating a sustainable environment, and creating a very peaceful world. Thank you, everyone.
Judges will now move to a 5-minute question and answer period. Only judges may ask questions. Judges, please raise a hand if you have a question.
Which of the products produced one clock, one day, have you tested which of those products is going to be more profitable? Is it the pots?
It's the pots.
Three, two,
our major production of our streamline is pots, because we realize that these plastic pots give an enriching for a new experience to your house, whereas beams can be used in your gardens or a bigger size.
How much do you sell the pots for, and where, and how did you kind of research and decide how much to sell them for?
It really depends. Like, we usually sell it for like $20 to $25, and we do online sale and also the offline. Offline right now is basically focused on our campus. We have Christmas sale and also during the environment day, because it's like a kind of discount. And also we not only sell the plants and also the only pots, and also during the environmental day we sell the like not really finished pots, which is a really cheaper, like $5.
So during the production, some of them doesn't come out really direct. If they are not perfect, you just reduce the price. Or if they have so much of one color, especially for the caps of the meal, which is blue, they're going for cheaper. And we just recently developed a new method on having an artificial crack in the middle of the pot, so separate the two colors. And those are a bit longer to make than normal pots. We try to sell them for $25. But the range is between $5 to $25.
And you do market research to how did you come up with that price?
The price is just based on the hours of volunteering and spent time in the lab. The market research has been done about the new product which is coming out later this year. It's about fully recycled trophies, which were supposed to be used for this, but unfortunately we couldn't get more in time because of the shortage of the engineers and external organization. That market research has been done. There is no absolutely similar product about it. Like in Australia, there are two types similar to it, not from fully plastic, in Netherlands. And they are selling for north of $170. So that's going to bring a huge revenue to us after the production. And obviously trophies are very high in demand in all ceremonies across universities and organizations. So the market research has been done by myself for that specific upcoming product. And about the clock, we only made the prototype. We haven't gone for the proper mold, because the cost of the mold has doubled after COVID. So we didn't literally have the funding to go for it.
Have you engaged in any potential retailers in that partnership?
We recently opened our new eBay channel, so that's going to be our new revenue. But on the other hand, we are hoping to plan it to go to the markets around Victoria. Like festivals or markets that's happening on a weekly basis. But directly, Precious Plastic Melbourne have come in and collaborated with Country Road, the big brand, and they produce some materials for them. We are hoping to negotiate with them and build those connections to be able to sell our products in their stores in the future.
In terms of, so it sounds like you're using like university resources in terms of the machinery to produce the pots based on the investment that you put into the project. So if there was a scale up and you were going to more markets, you needed more products, what's the plan there? And if there's ever a chance that you can't use those university resources?
I'm happy to take it. So the scaling up is the bottleneck of our program is the sorting plastic to different parts. Otherwise, the extruder can just pump out the products. It's just a matter of attaching the mold to the extruder. Sorting is the most...
Your time has expired. Judges, please join me in congratulating the